My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on applied data science with Python. This is lecture number 281. Just to recall my previous lecture, that is lecture number 280. In that particular lecture, we were discussing that given data set DN, this DN typically divided into three parts. What is my first part? Let me assume this is D train. This is, let me say, D cross validation. My third part is D test. That's what I discussed in my previous lecture, that is in lecture number 280. So we typically break it up into this D train is 60% and this DCV cross validation 20% and D test is 20%. That's what I discussed, isn't it? Of course, you can change, you can go for something like you can divide into 70%, 10% and 20%. Yes, in whatever way it works, you can divide, but typically these are the ratios. This even right here, it may be sometimes 70%, it may be sometimes 10%, it may be sometimes 20%. That's what I'm saying. In whatever way it works, but typically these are the ratios, 60, 20, 20. Isn't it? Typically these are the ratios that are used. All these breaking is random, that you should understand. We are breaking this data in random manner. Now, one problem that this introduces is, again, we are very clear here, the function that we are training is a KNN. The function that we are training is a KNN. We get nearest neighbor from NN, nearest neighbor from my training data set. Isn't it? You are getting nearest neighbor from my training data set. That's what we discussed, isn't it? And we obtain right K using cross validation. I can say like this, this K, if it is KNN, your K, you are getting K from cross validation, your nearest neighbor, you are getting from D train, isn't it? This is the function. This my KNN is the function, isn't it? This is my function in which I am deriving this K from cross validation set and nearest neighbors from D train. That's what I discussed, isn't it? We tested on unseen data. We tested on unseen data. Whatever accuracy we get on unseen data is what we will report as an accuracy for function f. There is one problem with this, which is of the total data that we have. What we discussed in my previous lecture, I will repeat this process. I divided this data set DN into three parts, D train, DCV, D test. This by using D train, we calculated nearest neighbors. By using cross validation, we calculated K. And we used this T test as an unseen data. We calculated this KNN's accuracy by using D test. That's what I did in my previous lecture. Let me say like this, total N data points. DN means how many data points are there? There are N data points that we have. We are only using, in these total N data points, we are only using 60%. We are only using 60% of data to compute, 60% of data to compute our nearest neighbor, because we are using 20% for cross validation and 20% for testing. We can't rid of using. You can't rid of using. This is an important concept. Let me write like this. You can't rid of using. I will repeat. We can't get rid of using the test set. The test set. This is an important point. I can't get rid of using test set because test set is always be unseen data. Your test data is always unseen. That's what I discussed, isn't it? Your test data always be unseen. It must always be unseen data. Therefore, I cannot get rid of using test set. We can't do anything about this, but can we somehow, instead of 60% of data to compute NNN, can we somehow, instead of using 60% of data to compute nearest neighbor, 20% of data for cross-validation for computing K. This is cross-validation data you are using for computing K, isn't it? Is there some way to use all of this 80% data? That's the problem here. I will repeat. Is there some way to use all of the 80% of data to compute KNN, to compute, let me say, can I make use? Is there some way to use? Otherwise, I will write. Is there some way to use this 80% data? This 80% of data, 80% of data to compute nearest neighbor. That's my question. In machine learning, this is most important rule. I will repeat, in machine learning, this is most important rule of machine learning. More the training data, the better is your algorithm. This is always true because most of the times this is true. More training data basically means there is more information that we are using to build your algorithm. But what happens when you use only 60% of total data to training? You are losing lot of information, but you can't get rid of this. That's an important observation. 20% of data for testing, this is mandatory. I cannot get rid. This is mandatory. 20% of data for testing, this is mandatory. This is compulsory or mandatory. We can't get rid of this. Is there some way for us to combine this data, this 60% of data for finding nearest neighborhood, this 20% of cross-validation data for finding right K. Is there any possibility of combining this D-train and DCV means D-cross-validations? Isn't it? I will repeat. Is there some way for us to combine these two sets, D-train and D-cross-validation, these two stages? Let me say this is stage one. Is there some way to combine these two stages? Which stage? D-train and DCV means cross-validation. To combine cross-validation and training in a very smart way. That's what is k-fold cross-validation. That's what k-fold cross-validation. Yes, that's a motivation. That's what k-fold cross-validation. This is an important observation. That's what is called k-fold cross-validation. Since we are doing KNN, I don't want you to confuse K in KNN. Let me repeat. Since we are doing KNN, I don't want you to confuse K in KNN. K in KNN. I don't want you to confuse K in KNN and K in K-fold. K in K-fold cross-validation. K in K-fold cross-validation. I will call this K-fold cross-validation as K-dash. Instead of saying K-fold, let me say K-dash-fold cross-validation. Let me call it as K-dash-fold cross-validation so that we know that there are two different numbers. These two K's, K and K-dash, these two K's are different and they are not same. That you must understand. K in KNN, K in KNN is different from K in K cross validation. In this particular context, in this particular case, K in the place of K cross validation, I am writing K dash fold cross validation so that I can differentiate between K in KNN and K in K cross validation, isn't it? These two cases, I will repeat, these two cases means K in KNN and K in cross validation. These two cases are different and they are not same. I will call cross validation part. I will call cross validation part as K dash. Now let's see K dash fold cross validation. Instead of saying K fold cross validation, let me call it as K dash fold cross validation works. Cross validation often written as CV. CV means cross validation. We understood what is the problem in breaking the data into three parts. Is there any better strategy to employ? I will repeat. We understood what is the problem in breaking the data into three parts. What are those parts? D-train, DCV, D-test. Is there any better strategy to employ? That I will discuss in my next lecture. That is in lecture number 282. Thank you very much. My dear friends, welcome to understand very in data that is zero. We were discussing